Yeah, boy. No fucks given right now. The goal is today, with this video, we're a Halo channel. But I have more knowledge in the football field, but I'm gonna display, I like basketball too. I'm gonna display elements in sports that distribute over to Halo itself. My theory that I've been developing, working on, is that I see Halo as a sport, so therefore, if that is the case, elements of these sports, but there is elements of sports that connect in every sport to soccer, football, basketball, hockey, whatever the case may be. There's usually the same fundamentals at the core. We're gonna demonstrate that. Okay. Basketball, I'd say it's more comparable to foot to not football to Halo than it is than football is to Halo. Obviously, in basketball, there's five players on the court at a time. They have a bench as well. There's distributed minutes between players. And then there's also a foul system that determines if you get a particular amount of fouls, you can possibly foul out the game. Which doesn't happen in Halo. There's defs. Maybe, in Breakout, if that was a game type, there was kind of lives in that per round, but in Halo, it's a per in this particular sport, we don't really have a bench. So we don't have backup players. With Halo, you ain't got no timeouts. You don't. You gotta back up players. You can't stop the game. It's just the only time the game stops is when the game ends and you're switching between rounds, or you might have to do a redo. Basketball, I'd say. It relates more to Halo in the fact that it's more dynamic. In football, you're kind of more limited as the balls, like there's more players on the field, 11 offense, 11 defensively, at any kind of phase, offensive, defensive, or special teams as three phases.
They looked very stable.
Yeah, with basketball, it's like Halo, like you can make a play, you're moving around the map. You're gonna have to make individual plays.
They were pretty solid there. I was
And
very impressed with the balance they displayed, guys.
yeah, it's kind of
Different
more
people
limited, but
carrying the load, scoring, making assists,
right now I'm playing.
unselfish play.
There's positions
Everything was
in
working for them to
basketball,
get
but
that victory.
nowadays, if you be
I'm
paying
Sacramento
attention
starting five.
to basketball and how it's
Cole,
kind of
he's our point
evolved,
guard.
is that
Aldridge
everybody
out there
has to
with
be
DeMarcus
dynamic.
Cousins. Then there's
Just like
Anderson,
Halo, like
and it's
the smaller the
Stauskas at the
roster
shooting
is,
guard
the more
position.
dominant your roster has to be.
The
Okay, like
rebound
in
by
basketball, there's
Anderson
more players, but
on
generally
defense,
you need to still
Denver.
have
They're moving
a
on
few
after the
players
tough
that are
loss
good
they took
overall,
by
and then you
hands
have
of
your
the
role
Blazers.
players. But
You
that's
just couldn't
because
get the
your
ball to
roster is
basket
deeper,
that day,
so
guys, no matter
you can't
how
have
many
like
plays you
fucking
make
10
at the
players on your
defensive
roster
end. It's hard to
all
overcome such a
be all
lack of
good
rich
overall
offenses.
players.
Yeah,
You
the
want
high
that, but
quality
I'm not
South
saying like
Pavilion
they're all
floor
really
between
high
Foreman.
at the level.
They
There's
have
a
nobody to
certain
blame
skill
but
chart.
themselves. They need to
There
work a lot
isn't
harder to get good shots
one.
today. And so it's the Kings getting on the board
Or
first.
they're
Here's
not
Lawson.
at the high
He
level
plays
of
it up
that
and
of
banks
that
it in.
chart. My bad.
Well, they just gave him
Losing
two
train of
bullets
thought here.
defensively. You're going to have to tighten things up here. That's not a good sign.
I guess,
A moment
yeah.
to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Yes,
Right now,
Coach.
okay.
I caught up with the Nuggets
Halo,
head coach.
Halo wise,
He
I'm
talked
kind of
about
losing
the
track of this
respect
because
he
I'm
has
like
for the
ranting
game,
right here.
about
I'm just
DeMarcus Aldridge,
spontaneously
and how
playing a
tough it will
game,
be for them to
ranting
slow him down,
about
saying
how the
that
elements
Aldridge
of
is
this.
tough
I can even
because he
do
can
it
score facing up
working
or
at
facing up
McDonald's,
to
how
the
it's the
basket.
same.
And
I
with
can
his
compare
length,
the
it's
elements
tough to
of
bother his shot.
certain aspects of
Aldridge
the job
can deny him the ball
relate to
with his
Halo
length and just try to
fundamentally.
make it as hard as
When we talk about
possible
things like
every touch.
rotation, two-man
Together
jobs,
we'll see
three-man
how
jobs,
successful they
2v2,
are.
winning
Thanks,
one-on-one
Doris.
battles, offense.
Now, here is
There's
Lawson.
offense and defense
He's
in
coming off a
Halo. Yes,
10-point game
people.
against Portland.
Slayer,
Here's
whether it's
Fournier.
Slayer
The shot
or
is off.
what the,
Nice
like, okay,
D
let's
from
think about it. Okay, in
Cousins.
basketball, there's this
So is
ball that
Sacramento.
determines possession, who's in control of the game.
They
There's
set
a
the screen.
scoreboard. Just there's the time.
Here's
Okay,
Aldridge.
Halo has time. Halo has a scoreboard.
And a foul on the
So what if
shot. He'll go to
things
the stripe for
control
two.
possession and dot and control
First
the
trip to the free
game?
throw
It's
line
power
for him in
weapons and
this one.
power ups. That's what changes Halo.
And the
The
first one at
map
the line is
is this
good.
is the basketball court. Halo has various different maps. okay.
There's not a lot you can say that hasn't
we're playing
been
on like host. Let's talk about connection. Okay, like I'm on. We're playing away right now. I'm the Kings. Playing the Denver Nuggets. We're at their home, so they're hosting right now. We're at a disadvantage.
Here's the general. He had a career game last time out. Bucket after bucket. Feeds to Aldridge. 11 feet away. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Nuggets have gone 2 of 5 here.
What was he gonna
say? 40% so far to start out the game. That gives them the lead.
Nice soft touch. So offense and defense.
Kings have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one.
Especially that's evident in objective game types. When we look at slot games, obviously that's the most predominant. But in strongholds, whoever has the Hill's arm is the one in control, has possession of the rock.
Here's the general, Lawson defending. That's good.
Well, he's off to a good start, and he's a guy who we know if he gets going early, he can give you problems all day.
What else? See, what makes Halo more dynamic is that, okay, like the basketball court. It's the same. It's obviously the same field at every any place you go to, whether you fly out to Boston or whether you fly out to LA. Still going to be the same. But in Halo, it's different. What makes it more challenging is a dynamic map. There's different jumps. There's different maneuverabilities. There's different type of weapons. Obviously, like we're comparing a physical sport to
could be the first of many mid-range jump shots we see.
Hand-eye coordination, balancing a lot of stuff in your brain. But yeah, there's a lot of things to be good at in Halo with different weapons. You got different guns. Be good at in basketball. There's different techniques, you know. Like, okay, let's just okay. I'm just gonna keep breaking it down. Like, okay. I'm just going on rant again. This is all just fucking random off the top, and it's like I'm also concentrating trying to win this game too. But okay, offense and defense. We talked about that. Individual skills. There's different elements. Okay, in Halo, we talk about offensive players. Like, okay, people who can insert and be aggressive. There's, you know, the pass players who can hold down position. And hold position. Yeah, hold positions. Hold areas of the map. And just put down shots. And you need to be able to switch in between, obviously. So, yeah, in basketball, it's pretty the same thing. There's that. You can have a jump shot, or you can take it to the rim. Either you're attacking, or you have a jump shot. There's the post. You can be in the post, or you can be shooting on the wing like he just did right there.
He doesn't really scare a defense at all. You've seen him miss quite a few just like those.
Here's the general. 6 points for him. He dishes it to Cousins. Banked in off the glass.
You won the 1v1 battle. 1v1, bro. In every sport, you have to be good at the top tier level. You just can't be the perfect team player at every level and expect to just
first in scoring, first in steal.
Be able to win championships, especially Halo, with a four-man roster. Smaller team, the better the individuals have to be.
And the points that they're scoring per game that you
three players cannot just
really
compensate for that one player. If the other team has a full roster of four good players, then what are you going to do?
Also score in transition. Nice rebound in traffic, and that's his job.
Kings have gone 5 of 8 from the field, shooting over 62%.
2v2 battle. Still didn't shake my man. We try to pass the ball. He's in the 1v1. I'm still trying to run. Cousins is one of his 1v1 third back to defense. So the scoreboard at time we just talked about the same as Halo. So it's still the first quarter, and that's the big difference right there is that there's four quarters and there's a halftime where you take breaks.
Here's the general.
Ah, damn it. Hello? Okay then. You're not gonna, you don't need me to take, you're not gonna take me to work tomorrow? Okay. Bye. on the phone. Okay. Like, Marcus Aldridge here, Aldridge too. Like, we have to know the difference. Like, it's obviously different because there's different roles. Okay, in Halo, we talk about different roles, like, that were created. The support role, the aggressive, the objective role, and then the slayer role.
Right where it needed to be.
And, like, you can... And then some people, there's the main slayer one, main slayer two kind of deal. You know, and obviously in basketball, football... Well, we're going to just stick to basketball here. There's multiple positions. Point guard, the shooting guard, power forward, small forward, and center. So there's five different positions compared to Halo. There's three, but, like, again, you need to be switched... You need to be able to do all three.
The coach was really passionate in that last title, trying to do everything he can to get his message across.
Right now, like in Halo, we look at COG, everyone's pretty balanced. There's certain people that are stronger in other areas. Like Lethal, probably the best subject player. The second would be Snakebite on that team. And then obviously, like, the best sniper would be Roll 2. And then probably, like, everyone else can really snipe on that team, though. But, like, Roll 2 is, like, the primary sniper. Just like on a basketball team, there would be a primary shooter, scorer in certain times. Like, oh, Roll 2, we need you to clutch up, get the sniper, get some kills. Oh, Kobe, oh, we're going to pass you the ball. You need to clutch up, get some shots. The same kind of thing.
6 seconds left here in the opening quarter.
On this roster that I'm on for the Kings right now for basketball, I'm primarily that score shooter right now. I'm the point guard, which is supposed to be primarily a position that distributes the ball to other positions and creates shots and easier shots. Just like in Halo, support player, like the point guard is like the support player, weakening people and then setting up people for easy cleanups and multi-kills and giving them the ball, because typically you want to pass the ball, so you pass the possession, you pass the power weapon in Halo. You feed the power weapons to your slayer, just like you feed the ball to your scorer, so they can get the ball to the basket, so they can score points on the board.
Coming up. Neither team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And let's quickly break down the game we've been watching for the Kings, guys.
And the difference to this,
I guess,
point
now with
defense,
the Halo utilities, I guess it kind of just relates to how in basketball you just have various moves. So, like, farm abilities, you have various moves you can do, I guess, to juke people out, or I don't know, but it's a shooting game to walking down, running down the court and shooting walls, flying everywhere, shooting people.
Truly impressive numbers from him in a stellar
performance. Hey, talk about in special night. Elements like 2-2, 1-3, where there's ISO situations with stack bunches that are stacking the field, maneuvering the position. Like in basketball, ISO situations, isolating a player so he can be in a 1-on-1 particular, so they can, because they like the matchup, and then if he wins that, they usually score. Halo, there's a different part. You can distribute your players' presences across the map, and there's going to be certain parts of the map that's going to be ISO situations. It's like, how about bring up H2A? Lockdown. You're in the BR library setup. You extend over to sniper tower, control that sniper tower. You usually have only one player at that sniper tower. Especially if it's a game type like oddball, you probably have the ball somewhere in library or closing ramp, have the one in library, one BR3, and then one guy sniper tower just small dropping the blue. That guy in sniper tower is in the ISO situation.
Here's Stauskas. Tries again. In deep. Aldridge drops it in. Aldridge has got 7 points here in this quarter.
And as the game has gone along, they've gotten much more aggressive on the offensive boards.
You know, crashing the boards is really an effort thing.
You know, what else should I talk about?
If teams get tired, they usually take a break on crashing the boards. But they've done just the opposite here.
Let's check out the Western Conference standings right now that we're here in the new year. You look at Sacramento. Quite a season they've assembled here, guys. Perched up there in first place and playing terrific basketball, game in and game out.
Okay, I guess I'll start trying to connect parts of this game into some more Halo and see if we can find some more about rotations and all that other stuff. Halo, we talk about rotations and setups or across the map spawning, seeing lack of balance on the map, lack of distribution. Like in the map, as I'm surveying the field right now, I'm like, okay, I got two people to the left, two people to the right. We're not stacking up unless we're switching up the situation. Right now we're in a balanced front. So I have equal people to the left and to the right.
Looking for Aldridge, he gets it there.
Aldridge makes the play right there. That was a 2v1 and he made a play.
I
was kind of taking too long on the clock right there. So see the clock right there, there's a shot clock, 24 seconds. We cannot just be on offense the whole time. Like we only can be offense. There's a certain time before the shot clock expires, and then we just turn the ball over, and they have it. In Halo, it's when you kill people to put them on respawn, there's a time when they're on respawn is that opportunity that's created for you to create a play, right? I'm trying to see. Wait. Okay, yeah. So, I just lost my train of thought because I was like, how did that connect again? But yeah, so when in Halo, when you kill people and put them on respawn, you create that window of opportunity to create a play and further advance yourself towards the winning state. Just like in basketball, that's why there's a scoreboard. When you, there's obviously turn, you can turn the ball over, the other team can miss shots, or you can steal the ball. And you have possession of the ball again, and you have 24 seconds to score. And the more chances you have to score, the further you can get away from the other team. So if you don't capitalize, like, what if you steal the ball from the other team, and but you don't capitalize on it, you don't score, that you're not further extending your chances of winning or winning the game.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for Sacramento.
A lot of success from mid-range so far for them, guys. If nothing else works, they can always fall back on the jump shot.
And they've also been very productive from the foul line, getting there early and often.
Ty Lawson hits them both.
Well, just take a look at what Lawson's done tonight. He has 8 points, and he's done his job at the charity.
All right, we'll talk about more of the balance concept.
And that's a good
place that's
to
what
get them.
We're pushing in this Halo scene, that, the SBRT slash E. So we'll try to connect to the theme.
Can't afford to give him that kind of look.
That's going to be the biggest thing I'm going to talk about right now, I guess.
As a defender,
right now, I'm in a 1v1 battle. I see two people to my right, so the court is still evenly stacked, two to the right, to the left.
It's tipped.
Teammate just made a play. Oh, we didn't get the steal. I tried to go offense too quickly right there. Tempo, we talk about the T-part timing in regards to Halo. And in any sport, timing is very imperative, whether you're a football receiver running a route or on the defensive side, a cornerback disrupting the timing of a route. Halo, like delaying, staying alive, delaying the timing of the team's push where they're not able to kill you, and the team in more of a collective chain of same time of death. Right now, see, we got three stacked to the right, so we're in an ISO kind of stack situation.
Give
me some room to get the jump shot with that screen.
He's got so much junk in his trunk.
With the screen concept in basketball, it's angled, just like in Halo. Whenever you should pinch, when you're pinching on a guy, you should collapse and take different angles so they have less escape routes.
Some solid defense from Aldridge.
That's what you want to do.
Kings leading now by six.
Let's talk about that. That's more of a defensive thing too. And now I see my guy go to the right. I didn't really juke him out right there, or I didn't go correctly on the screen right there. Should have kept going hard right. is off. Duncan missed on the spray. Denver the other way still up. This time they faced off, it was by six. Check the paint.
And in that first matchup, they got absolutely manhandled on the boards. Guys.
In basketball, we know that we can't stand in the paint more than have both feet in the paint for longer than 5 seconds, or that's a defensive violation.
It's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. For Denver, they have been coming through at the charity stripe. They've made 7 of their 8 attempts. First one falls for. Some changes for Sacramento.
I don't see anything in Halo that kind of would connect to that.
And the first half ends in a close one. Kings.
Well, Tim, and looking at that first half.
But again, we are still talking about core fundamentals.
Okay, guys, let's focus and get down to business. Now, here's a few things I took away from the first half. Our passing has been...
SBRT, we talk about situation, level balance,
looking at the game for
rotation,
the general,
timing,
14 points, and he's also getting up some nice assists here and there, too.
Well, he's going to have to continue to play this way, Clark, because this offense thrives on his passing ability, and they've got
to
go right
now. Balance front, 2-2.
Reed and JaVale McGee. Then it's Lawson.
Oh,
and
shit.
In at the two. That's the group.
Horrible
the
pass. Turnover.
Now that's how to finish the break. Throw down with
textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
And it's the Kings with the ball. The Nuggets getting the bucket. The shot's good from the general.
And he's made the most of his chances, hasn't he? Really needs to continue to work for those good looks.
Lawson with it. Fareed setting the pick for Lawson. Just 4 to shoot. And he uses
no.
Lawson's got 12 points in the game.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Well, that's important because this game, I think, is going to be decided by who controls the paint.
Rotate too many inside.
That one's goodbye game.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate shooting.
We're talking about in Halo when we lose numbers, it's like uneven fronts, 4v2, 4v3.
Just a little over 90 seconds gone in the third quarter.
Those same type of scenarios can be created in the football with, or not football, my bad, basketball with the pick and roll situation.
He's been on the money with his game.
The closer you get to the hoop, once you beat that man, they have less people to defend the hoop inside.
Trills the three-pointer, and the Kings lead by 6.
You typically always have the advantage, and that's what you always want to be working from.
It's
like in Halo, you don't really want to be playing flag in even 4v4 situations.
Here's the general, Aldridge a screen. Here's the general, and again it's Sacramento converting.
That would be 4 in a row for them now as they have come racing out of the gate to start this second.
Right there, that was a kind of a bad play. Like, it's kind of like shitting on two people by yourself when you don't need to do that. When that was not literally the correct play, like in Halo, putting yourself in a bad position when you could just rotate somewhere else safer to get teammate help. And in this case, for me, I could have rotated that ball, passed it. Pass it to somebody else who has an easier time. Instead, try to take the hard route.
There's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. It goes on Kenneth Faree.
Well, DeMarcus Cousins in
doing the E part, the E, the execution.
He's added a steal to
the SBRT sets you up
not a big number, but
consistently to be in advantageous situations. But in the end, you need to execute, and then whether you put yourself in a good position or not.
So he makes 1 of 2 as the second one misses. The Nuggets trail by 6. Lawson outside.
They're trying to get him in the ISO because he saved the matchup. It's a big versus a small right there.
Rolling now. 5 straight hoops to start this quarter.
A dude 7 feet or something or taller.
Since the halftime break, terrific start to the third quarter. The general passes to Aldridge, 11 feet away. That one goes. Count it. Aldridge has got 15.
Nice pass. Nice. That one was
time
right
in the rotation.
Target. Little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the third.
That timing is married with that rotation.
Here we go. Lock at six. Austin right side. Misses off the left iron.
I tell you what, for what's really a
not able to win the hit 1v1.
He looked a little nervous on that release.
To the right side. Here's Stauskas, and again at Sacramento converting.
Boy, this is the kind of shooting performance coaches dream of. It makes their job so much easier.
Kind of like in Halo when you're playing in the pro leagues or with high caliber players, you know, when you have a weak player, a one shot, they typically clean them up. I guess the equivalent of that would be in basketball. If you were wide open, don't make your shot. That would be not being able to clean up that one shot.
The NBA right now, first in scoring, first in steals, and they're also number one in shooting percentage. This is a team that prides itself on taking high quality shots.
And the points that they're scoring per game that you talked about is really a result of great offensive execution. I mean, this is a club that works well together. They get great looks, and they'll also score in transition.
Ty Lawson hits them both. And Sacramento has possession. Six-point game. They've got the Pistons ahead of them in their next game
stacking
in Detroit. And that will conclude.
They're doing a 2-3 ratio.
Roll, and he dunks it down.
Beautiful pick by the big man, Cousins.
For Denver, they've gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second half. Tremendous efficiency. Watson the pass to Dixon.
One-on-one predict here. Their play.
Stauskas and Watson with the block. And they get it back. Passes to Stauskas. Gay outside.
See, pass it. Gay.
And he can't extend the lead to double digits.
The timing right there. If I just had passes to Gay initially rather than passing to Stauskas then to Gay and him passing it to Gay, that delay, just that little second delayed enough time for the guy to make compensate on his rotation and come back and put enough pressure on Gay where he's not able to make clean a shot.
Kings leading now by six.
Halo, that would be knowing in certain setups, like timing wise, like what is the fastest rotation? Do I need to bump this guy to this position and then have him bump here, or do I just not bump anybody and rotate to this open spot as fast as possible? And then what's the quickest route there? That late second, I mean, not helping your teammate stay alive for that time. Having him in an uneven battle, maybe a 2v1 battle rather than a 2v2, or maybe he's struggling on his 1v1 and you help him out.
Really good look at the basket after being freed up by the pick.
We say it all the time, the execution was excellent, the result not as good, but good ball movement anyway.
Now, here is Lawson, 16 points for him.
How about that? Gets it off right in the face of the big fella. Quick release.
And operating on the perimeter like that negates some of the height disadvantage, too.
Here's the general. To the left side wing. Hits. Count that one from Stauskas. Stauskas has got 7 points
diversion
here in this quarter.
Gotta love the inside-out game there, guys.
Lawson dishes to McGee. Back to Lawson. That three off the mark. Kings leading now by six. Cousins with a screen on Lawson. The general passes to Stauskas.
Shit.
Here's the general. Sacramento moving it around. He had a nice open look right there.
Superb assist there.
Talk about aggro a lot. Maestro on that. Lots of distraction. Focus, attention.
Lawson outside.
Version. Basketball, I guess, who has the aggro is the person who has the ball and the people who are, we know that are threats or hot players.
It's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over.
Kind of like in Halo, if someone was a power weapon, you'd be very cautious against someone of a sniper on the map.
One of the benefits of keeping the other team's point totals low is that it takes some pressure off of your offense. When you can hold the team below,
someone's good all, you know, that's superb. Well, two on the other team, you can go off at any time. Denver with a platoon, you gotta be careful. He's a threat.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but
extra close attention to those folks.
No, that's for sure, because this guy's too good.
You can create the opening when your teammates are not being disciplined. It's like maybe you're in Halo, you're in a setup, you're in the zone, you're not watching your zone, your cross map, and listening to other callouts. You give another player an opportunity to make an easy play, get the first shot on you. In basketball, when you're not looking for that ball guy, I'm paying attention to him, I'm looking at him, maybe I'm not looking at my guy anymore, my guy just rotates, gets open, and gets it, creates an easy shot for himself.
That one off the back iron and out. Sacramento leading by six. Screen by Cousins.
At the rotation, they rotate it inside because they saw me trying to get inside, and the Cousins get inside. Could get out to the outside.
Since halftime is about as good as you could possibly ask for, guys.
Now's the time to put the pedal to the metal, boys. Keep firing those deep balls and
I guess like distributing and seeing certain ways of attacking the basket. It's kind of really the same concept as how you would try to run a flag back to your base in Halo. Different routes, different ways to do it.
Started by Augustine. The kick out to Anderson.
Different pick schemes that we can do for us to attack the basket.
Fader on the way. Good. And now it's an 11-point Kings lead.
Might as well just take it into his own hands and make that big lead even bigger.
Here's Augustine dunking with the block.
My team had wiped my ass right there.
Now here's McLemore, guarded by Augustine. Harris on the double team. High post Cousins. Thomas Robinson comes up with a rebound. Robinson's got four rebounds now tonight. Leonard kicks to Augustine. Robinson up top. There's the dish to Harris. Missed. And as we end,
was not able to capitalize. Nick.
And now with our State Farm assist of the game, a replay showing one of 10 tremendous assists in this game from the general.
What an excellent all-around game too, Kevin. 10 assists just shows you, you know, what we already know about him. But
yeah, we just talk about it in Halo, like the
understands the offense and
that game. What makes it very close is the fact that the E part, it can happen at any time. You can E at any time, make a bad play good. It's like in basketball, the plays are constantly breaking down. Maybe I call a play on the playbook, try to execute it. Things are not working out, they're disrupting our time, and we can't get open. Shot clock's running down, you're just going to have to create a play yourself. Second Halo, you might rape a person.
Anderson dishes to Duncan. Anderson passes to the general.
I'm in an ISO situation.
Shoots a fader. That's good. The general's got 26 points.
Yeah, no problem knocking down that shot. And a little more damage inflicted on another defensive lapse.
They set the pick. And Augustine kicks to Robinson. There's a screen by Robinson. Harris outside.
And any game is a game of numbers. Talking about Halo, it's a game of numbers. How many people are down? Constantly assessing that. Where are the numbers at? Where are they stacked out on the map?
Zagora, guarded by McLemore. And here
probably
going
to eventually do a football analysis, too.
He kicks it to Duncan. That's good. And now it's a 12-point Sacramento lead.
And guys, what do you think
right
about
there, fast break, playing really fast. I guess in Halo, there's three dimensions when it comes to offensive play. When we talk about like maybe first layer game type, for example, or even it can happen in strongholds, as the game type like that. I wouldn't say it really could happen on the game type like flag, because it's not very dynamic on how you can move on the map compared to Slayer, just because there's two static bases. But the three, there's three ways. There's the offense. There's the offensive way where you're constantly just swarming on the map, shifting from position to position, not allowing the team to breathe and get room to be able to make a coordinated push and have spacing.
Stauskas comes in for Ben McLemore. And now Doris Burke.
Better way is the aggressive or the passive way, setting up, controlling specific parts of the map. Both aggressive and defensive, we know where they're going to spawn.
The shot's good from the general.
But it's just, I guess, the tempo of the play. And the last one is the split spawning, where you can be passive and aggressive. They have a partly have a passive setup, and then be playing aggressive to where you purposely make part of their team spawn on your passive side of the map in a vulnerable position where they're easy to pick off.
I don't know who was supposed to be on him there, but clearly a mistake by the defense.
Aldridge with a screen on Lawson. Here's the general, and again it's Sacramento converting.
What a top-notch game he's having.
Thing in this basketball, like, there's this regular tempo right now, they're playing regular tempo, and there's also there's fast break situations when we're all running down the court, like maybe it's a quick, we're just deciding to speed it up, play fast. Sometimes there's certain teams, or maybe when people are tired, they're not able to be good and effective in defending those scenarios.
Off the screen, and the serious dunk to finish it off.
It could be speed,
this is getting ridiculous.
Matchup
they can't possibly
problems.
Keep this run going much longer.
It could be miscommunication problems on the defense. If they're trying to do a zone, if they're trying to do a man, who's rotating where. All that happens, the same communication happens on the court. The opponent hears your communication. In Halo, the opponent don't hear your communication.
And the Kings pushing it up now. And again, another shot trained.
Football,
the
opponent hears your communication.
The general's got 10 points now, just in this quarter.
But there's certain, there's a lot of code words, and they change it up every week. Some defenses can read your communication and predict what you're doing.
Lawson's feet. Lawson's got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. Kings have gotten seven of their eight shots to fall here.
In Halo, it's the same thing. We stress, we're trying to make a movement of watching film, gaining pattern recognition.
Here's the general.
A lot of times, some of these players don't even need to hear the communication. They're just seeing where the bodies are. What they know our tendencies from watching film. They can predict what's going to happen, what play is going to be made, where the ball is going to be passed, what kind of move he's going to get once he gets the ball. That same awareness you can gain that in basketball. Oh, not basketball, in Halo.
Here's the general, Lawson defending.
Oh, he blocked my shit. Played it too slow.
Terrific defense right there to prevent.
Playing on that Hall of Fame. Hardest difficulty, even. That one hesitation is gonna fuck you up.
Well, he attacks the rim on the dead run.
Aldridge with a screen on Lawson. Here's the general. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. The general's got 36.
He had a whole lot of space to get that shot off.
Yeah, I don't think the defender did a good job there of getting over the top of the screen.
It's stolen. Duncan with a screen on Lawson. Passes it to Stauskas. The three.
Ooh, that was bad. He hit all board.
That he's given up some inches to a few of the other guys on the floor.
Dixon, and there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. First free throw is good.
And the Kings making a change.
Cousins is checked in. Two shots. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
They're locked in from the charity stripe this half. Not a miss yet.
And they're going to have to continue that pace, Clark, because they're down, and anytime you're losing, you got to take advantage of every offensive opportunity you have. They can't afford to give them that kind of look.
Well, they came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to fight over the top of that.
Now, here is Lawson. Ukocha, he's covered by Anderson. Lawson outside. Six to shoot. Off target with his three. Kings leading now by 15.
He did not capitalize off that slow rotation.
Here's the general. The pass to Stauskas. Pass to the general.
Throw it up. Last connecting part, I would say, just maybe get more in depth with what I was talking about earlier, connecting. Like on the defensive side, see, like, I guess we can correlate defense with setups in correlation with Halo, because that's where the passive defensive play would come from. There's various different setups depending on what you want to do. Just 17. Like in basketball, or yeah, in basketball there could be man to man, there could be zone. You play 2-3, 3-2.
McGee's shot is off.
You know, that's a problem he has. I mean, not being able to knock down that open
jumper. A lot
jumper.
Of different shit.
I think it happens far too often.
Left side, Anderson. Left side, Anderson. Shot clock at 6. Here's the general. Lawson defending. No good from the general.
Well, he turned a high percentage shot into a low percentage shot by trying to go to the fadeaway.
Damn it, I did not get a good field position.
Drains the three-pointer. 23 points in the game.
And he has picked it up.
A lot of bad things going on the play. Anderson had a bad pass.
Here's the
general. Oh, shit.
Anderson dishes to Aldridge. Kings moving the ball around. Takes the 13-footer. Denver grabs the miss.
McGee's bad repeating them.
Outside for Lawson. Good on the triple.
Lawson's he got made a play, but it's
That's
too late.
In a row from long range. Shoddy defense there. Far too slow to react on the closeout.
This is a very unorganized ramp. That will be put on YouTube.
The screen on Lawson. The general passes to Stauskas. And once again off the mark by Sacramento.
They've been able to get out to this lead without really getting a very reliable performance out of him from the field.
McGee sets the pick for Fareed. Fires the three. Sacramento grabs the miss. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead.
I think this is a game they have to feel good about as we wind through the final moments here in what looks to be a solid win.
Or I can do the ice play where I don't do any air work.
Yeah, remarkable team effort, Kevin. Everybody got involved, and that paid dividends.
And so taking a look at their season record, this will be win number 31 on the year.
With a solid strategy, building on that first win in this season series,
I kind of do that same concept in Halo,
and with one left to
you're
play
in an ISO or you're by yourself a little too early in a certain spot, create a distraction where you pull, draw two players over to you, and somebody will eventually come and get your help and for the cleanups.
He would constantly find them more often than not.
Stauskas, the pass to the general. Good on the triple. The general's got 41.
And the crowd here, of course, not happy about the outcome. But you know what? We saw a team tonight that came in prepared to do battle on the road.
Nice shooting.
We're determined to steal this game. And
so it's the Kings.
This concludes the stream. Appreciate y'all listening.